People say, where do I go when I die? Okay. Let me ask you a question just now. What did you have for lunch today? What did you have for lunch? Salad? Where did you have lunch? Okay. Now, as I'm asking you a question, the memory is coming, right? And you can experience it as a sensation, image, feeling, or thought, right? Where was that before I asked you the question? Where was that experience before I asked you the question? Now, you know, traditional neuroscientists will say, it was in my brain, but I work with the best neuroscientists, my colleague, collaborators, Rudy Tanzi at Harvard, the chief neuroscientist and geneticist at Mass General Hospital. And I said, Rudy, next time you have a conference, and you had 150 of the best scientists. And I said, ask them where is memory stored in a cellular level? Guess what? Not one of them could answer. We know that when I asked you that question, and before you said salad, that there was a memory somewhere, but we can't find it in the brain. Can't find it in the brain. Do you remember the house you lived in when you were a teenager? Can you see it now? So what are you seeing? You're experiencing sensations, images, feelings, thoughts, because those memories are associated with other memories. If I go inside your brain, do you think I'll find a picture of your house? Or do you think there's some neural network where there is salad? So what happened? When I asked you the question, a sensation, image, feeling, thought arose from consciousness and then it subsided in consciousness. And that consciousness is transcendent. It doesn't exist in space-time. So where do we go when we die? Where that salad was before I asked you the question. Okay? We don't go anywhere because we are there all the time. Okay? In fact, every thought comes from there. Every memory comes from there. Every desire comes from there. Every bit of imagination comes from there. Insights, intuition, imagination, creativity, choice, all comes from there. And we have to be there in order to retrieve it. You retrieved it from your transcendent self. And being transcendent, it's not a space-time event. But as you actualized it, then there was a little space-time. Okay? Ramana Maharishi, when he was dying, people said, we are going to miss you. He said, but where am I going? What we call the physical world is a quality of awareness within awareness. What we call the mental world is a quality of awareness within awareness. What we call the universe is a quality of awareness within awareness. And if you can just anchor yourself in that little space, the openness that Eckhart was saying, it's your ticket to freedom. It's the ticket to freedom. Why? Because it's the you that never dies. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, water cannot wet it, wind cannot dry it, weapons cannot shatter it, fire cannot burn it. It's eternal, it's unborn, because birth is a space-time event. It doesn't die because death is a space-time event. A space-time event is part of the flux.
Hat dir dieses Video gefallen? Dann abonniere jetzt unbedingt diesen Kanal. Denn schon bald findest du hier den nächsten Beitrag von einem deiner Top-Mentoren.